Okay, we're going to now look at this idea of why is it that a PPF is a curve, which you can sometimes describe as concave to the origin, because it sort of looks like this bow shape here, which is concave if you look at it from this perspective, the origin. And the way that we would explain this is by looking at an economy which produces shoes and shirts, all right? So if we have this production possibility frontier showing out the possibilities depending on what we decide to produce as an economy, it means that producing the maximum amount of one good, so for example, 10 shoes, implies that you're making none of this other good. So to make 10 shoes, we're making no shirts. Now, this assumes that some factors are better suited towards producing one good rather than another. So for example, some workers are trained to make shirts and would not be very good at producing shoes. This is something that we refer to as imperfect factor substitutability. All of that means is that when we think about this economy, there are some shirt makers, right? Let's say that there are one or two shirt makers who are really, really good at making shirts. Those shirt makers, because they have the skills, they've got the tools, they've got the experience in making shirts, they're really, really good at it. If you said, I only want you to make you're the only people that want to make shirts, but you're the best people at making shirts, they will make 5 shirts in the economy. Well, and everybody else will work on shoes, and will make 9 shoes, but let these other 2 people make the shirts, and because they're so good at making shirts, they'll make the 5 of them. The reason why it's concave to the origin is that to say that we're going to only make shoes, it means that we say, okay, those people who are the best shirt makers, we don't want you to make shirts anymore. We want you to quit the thing that you're really good at and make the shoes, which you're not so good at. By getting them off of the shirts and putting them onto shoes, you're giving up all the expertise in making shirts. You lose 5 different shirts in order to gain this one shoe. The fact that you've got imperfect substitutability simply means that there are people who are good at some things and they're not as good at doing the other thing. And so, in order to increase production from 9 to 10 on the shoes, you would have to be the best shirt makers who are not very good at making shoes to make those shoes. They would be giving up these 5 shirts in order to make the 1 pair of shoes. Now, what that means as well is that this is something which is important. It means that there is increasing opportunity cost at the margin. As you go higher and higher, higher up here, the opportunity cost increases. Because to go from essentially the opportunity cost of this one pair of shoes costs us 5 shirts. It's a much higher opportunity cost than, say, this one here, where in order to make 4 shoes, we gave up 4 shirts. So here it was a 1-to-1 relationship. Here it's a 1-to-5 relationship. So one pair of shoes costs you 5 shirts compared to one pair of shoes costing you 1 shirt down here. And that's the reason why it's convex to the origin, or sorry, concave to the origin like that, because it is of the imperfect factor substitutability. Now, what does the straight line imply? The straight line implies that after moving a worker from shirts to shoes, they are able to produce exactly as many of one good as they stopped producing in the other. The workers are equally skilled at producing both goods, so therefore there are no expert shoemakers or shirt makers. A worker can switch from one to the other and be equally good at both. That's what we refer to as perfect factor substitutability. And if you have perfect factor substitutability, it just means that the opportunity cost is constant throughout. So perfect factor substitutability leads to a straight line. PPF means that the opportunity cost is constant along the PPF compared to this one here, where there's imperfect factor substitutability, which leads to a concave to the origin PPF, which means the opportunity cost increases as you make more for good. Now, one thing that we would have done in class is we would have thought of this idea of the island economy, right? So the island economy has 2 goods, coconuts and fish. If there are 10 people on the island, 5 climbers and 5 fishermen, each climber can harvest 10 coconuts per day, each fisherman can catch 10 fish per day, all the climbers are afraid of water, all the fishermen are afraid of heights. Draw a PPF for this economy. It's completely imperfectly imperfect factor substitutability, which means that the PPF is going to look something like this, right? This is, I mean, this is the ultimate concave curve because if you took those the fishermen away from fishing and tried to get them to make more tokens, they wouldn't do it because they're afraid of heights. And so therefore, if you have imperfect factor substitutability, therefore you've got this very, very concave PPF. And that's pretty much it. What you want to do with this topic is just really get as much practice as you can looking at different multiple choice questions, looking at different short answer questions, which give you a chance to practice the type of shifts and pivots that you'll often see for questions on production possibility frontier.